Here's what you will need in order to follow along with us during these videos. Before we get started, you should know that you will find links to everything that I mentioned in this video in the description down below. The first thing you're going to need to download is Node.js. What this is going to allow you to do is to avoid a lot of the unnecessary hassle and setup that comes with learning JavaScript by setting up a web page and linking your JavaScript files to that. What this is going to allow you to do is just experiment with JavaScript itself in its own environment. What Node.js also will allow us to do is to create servers and automated bots that we will be creating as projects later on this channel. The next thing you're going to need is a text editor and an IDE, or an integrated development environment. The IDE that I suggest for beginners of all programming languages would be Visual Studio Code. It's developed by Microsoft and has support for nearly every software language that I can think of. I would also recommend downloading Notepad++. This will allow you to more easily take notes of your software designs and essentially kind of prototype everything that you want to do outside of the IDE. And in general, I just find that Notepad++ is superior to the Notepad that comes with Windows by default. The next thing you will need is access to the command line in one form or another. This can be either through the default command line, which you can reach by clicking Start on your computer and then typing in CMD. This will bring up a command line option that you can click. Another option would be the PowerShell, which you can get to by clicking Start and typing in PowerShell or Windows PowerShell. You can also use the command line that comes directly within Visual Studio Code. Any of these options will work, and we will explore all of them in one way or another throughout these videos. Optionally, you can also download Git. What Git is a version control system. What this allows you to do is to set version markers for your software. So if you're creating software and you make a mistake of some kind that you, for some reason, cannot reverse, you can simply go back to a different version marker that you have set through Git. You can also grab a GitHub account, which Git and GitHub kind of go together like peanut butter and jelly. GitHub is a site that allows you to export your Git information and your software as a whole externally to their website. It's free, and you can create public and private repositories, is what they're called, and you can share your code easily through there. Once you download all of that software, again, the links for each of the things that I've described are in the description down below. Then we can get to the real nitty-gritty. Let's get started.